Hey everyone, welcome back. It's EthanAVideos, and we're back again with another video. And yes, my face cam's on, I know that. And yes, my closet doors are open, the clothes. Today I'm going to be showing you who wants to become modders and just, like, maybe just want to get into creating some stuff for modders. How to make a, building kind of like this in Blender. Just kind of screwed around with the roof a little bit, but how to make a building like this. This is not you can go into the building in FS19. I did not make it so people can go in the building. And as you can tell, it's got no floor. It's just going to be a placeable in my map I'm making. And the roof won't look like this. I kind of was goofing around with the roof. My first time doing an angled roof like this. So, I'm kind of new to the Blender. I'm not the greatest, so. But I'm going to show you. This is supposed to be like concrete color. I have to put some textures on this. Like, I'm going to put some metal on here. Maybe some metal here. And there is some stuff you can do where all this stuff can be one plane or whatever you want to call it, or it can be all separate planes. So say, oh, right door, I don't like this door, so I can remove it, you know, or something, so I can edit it later on, basically. So I'm going to show you how I create this in Blender. Right now this is in Giant Editor. I'm going to show you how I create this, and I'm also going to show you how I export it. First off, let me just close this junk down, because we don't need this. Come on, close down today. Okay. Before we get into this, though, I do have something I want to tell you. So stick to the end of what I'm telling you, my message, and we'll get into doing this. So, let me get in this. Hey everyone, want to hang out in a great community that is growing, we're friendly, we're always happy to see new people here? Well, you should join my, Discord server. We're trying to grow, we even have one boost, now that's not much, but yeah, we even have one boost, we have 11 mods, we have 41 roles, who added a new role here, but anyways, we have 30 members, and we have 40 members in all, so, we're trying to make a great community. It's a fan base community, and if you want to become a member and have fun playing games, need help with something, you can always contact us. So invite link will be across my screen, and I'll also have it down in the video description, so come join, hang out with us. Okay guys, so you're back from it, so either you can just open up the Blender from wherever it is. Well, first you'll need Blender, I guess. I'll have a link down to the, in the description for Blender. It's available for Linux and Windows, if I'm correct. I'm running Windows 10 64-bit. And then you can go, like, I believe, instead of doing, I don't know if this would work, though, but basically call it test. And then you come here and you type, I think it's just Blender, right? No, Blend, okay. And then convert it, and then you got a blend right here, test blend. And yes, it will open up Blender too. I don't know if you can actually create it or will come up with an error. Okay, so it does come up, but in case you don't do it this way, which I don't do it this way, I just wonder if it would work that way, which it will, then I open up Blender, I can delete this cube, or I can come up into here, File, New, and then I hit General, or I can just select this and hit Delete on my keypad. I use a desktop that has keyboard, and then right on side it has number pad which makes it pretty easy for some stuff. But yeah. So what I do before is I go up here and I go to, come on, mesh, cube, and then I work on how I want to size this cube with X, Y, and Z. So this is its width. So just size that up to something you think will be. You don't have to exactly follow my things. You just can be like, okay, that looks fairly good. You know, stuff like that. This is the height of it from top to bottom. And then you can come on over here. And let's see, what is that? I can hit G. So if I hit G, G, and then I can move it around like this. And say if I don't like it, so let me hit G and do this. Say I don't want it up here. Then I can just right click and it snaps it down to the last action I performed. And then I can hit G and say I want it here. Then I can left click it and it can be here. So just to keep that in mind, in case you guys end up doing something you don't like. And then you can hit Shift R or R, Shift R. And then you can rotate it like this. So that's just kind of explaining how some of this junk may work. By the way, how you move around like this, that is me pressing my middle mouse button, my scroll wheel. Let me see if I can show you this. Okay, my middle mouse button, there's a scroll wheel in the middle of my mouse. I just push down on that and then move my mouse around, and that's how I do that. And when I let off, I can zoom in and out by scrolling on that scroll wheel. That's how I can also do that. So just add that right there for now. This is your rotation bar. If you have any ideas with anything like this, like for example, if you have any experience with Giant Editor, then you'll recognize this right here. You recognize something like this. So yeah, that's basically what I had to say there. So for me, I just kind of turn this a little bit. Alright, let's just, I don't know where we want to put this. If you hit tab, you can go into edit mode, and the reason I mainly use edit mode for this is because of this little guy right up here, which is called face select. Basically, you can like hit E for extrude or something, and you can, by moving your cursor, you can bring it in and out. If you don't want to perform the action you're doing, you can hit right mouse button. And if you do want to keep, if you like what you did by extruding, then you hit left. And then you can save the action. You can select faces like this. So you can only work on like one face. So say I want to make this wider this way or something. And that's how I kind of work on the building. I use it for how, I basically make one block till it looks good how I like it, and then I hit duplicate, and then that's how I do it. Well, enough yakking. Let's get into it. So I'm going to call, I like to try to keep my stuff organized. So I'm going to call this, we'll start like here. Give me 1 second. So we'll call this left wall, and there we go, left wall. Guess that looks pretty good. Kind of making a little bit of a bigger building. I don't actually, you know what, let's make this a little bit longer. Because we're making a little bit of a bigger building. Now, if you notice, the plane's not straight with each other. It's kind of at an angle, the plane. Well, it's straight with each other. It's just kind of angled a little bit. It's not straight going across. So that was my fault, and I'll fix that. Okay, so if you hit tab again, you go back to object mode. Then we go back over here, and we go and try to straighten it a little bit. Okay, that looks pretty good. Might still not be exactly perfect, but it'll do. So I'm thinking about doing an angled roof, which will be kind of like this. So to kind of make that look right, we might have to bring one wall up higher than the other wall, just to kind of make it look right. And I don't know, I'll just show you how I do it, and that's about it. So now there are cuts. There are exactly three cuts: cut here, and a cut here. So you'll have to raise it here, raise it here, raise it here, and raise it here. So basically select this, raise it to how you think it will look. Think that'll look pretty good. And then we'll just select, hit E, raise it up till it looks straight with that. Okay. That looks pretty darn good. Okay, now we'll just do the same to these two. Now, they might not be perfect. Just try to get them as best as you can. The better you can get them, the better they'll look. And just keep in mind, every time you hit the left key, confirm the action, and you're like, oh, I didn't like that. If you hit E again, you make another cut here. So that's just going to make more of a pain for you. So say I'm like, oh, this doesn't look high enough here or something. So I'm like, I'll fix it. I'll just hit E. Well, you won't be able to go back. You'll just hollow out, and you'll have like a side here, side here, side here, and a side here, and then in the middle will be hollowed out. So you can't go back on that action that way. So the wall looks fairly good in my opinion. Probably could be a little bit better, but it's pretty good. So now we just go back, and then it kind of shows a little bit better. Right here is not perfect, and right here is not perfect. Yeah, I already know that. And if you look on this side, you notice it's not too perfect either. By duplicating object, you hit shift D, but your cursor has to be in this viewing plane. See where this plane is? Your cursor has to be over here. It can't be over on the side panels. What I recommend for when you're doing anything like this is you hit right, and it snaps it back to where it was duplicated, and then you can move it out by using these three arrows. Move it out to where you think it looks pretty good. And like I told you, I was thinking about having a angled roof. I kind of have changed my mind. I'm going to have a flat roof, and then it's going to angle up. So I'll just show you how that's going to work. I'm not going to try explaining it too well. So that looks fairly good in length, I guess, or width from each other. Probably around there is pretty good. So, yeah. Okay, so now comes the time to create walls in the back wall and the front wall. Let me just go up here, add mesh cube, and then we're going to work on sizing it. So, If you're wondering how I'm just quickly, like, making it move in width and stuff, real quickly without, like, tapping these guys, if you run over them with your cursor, you get, like, a little two arrows going opposite directions. And if you click, and if you move your mouse from side to side, it will move the numbers. And it's kind of a little bit easier instead of, like, clicking it or something, or just trying to figure out which... what your X, Y, and Z you want it to be, like typing it out. So okay, so it looks like in the width of these two walls, it looks like it seems to fit pretty good. So let's just raise this up. Okay, now we're gonna start on its height. So that's kind of simple too. Let's see. So it's just kind of gotta go up just a little bit more. Okay, so that looks pretty good from what I can see. So we kind of got this. Kind of thinking these walls, I kind of want to make them a little bit longer this way. Let me just quickly kind of change the name a little bit. So let's go with wall. Cube, we're gonna make that back wall. And the way I export these into an i3D, the reason I go through and label them all is so I can go through and re-edit them. I'm not like other people that when I make buildings like this, I make it so where you can't make certain little adjustments in there. So that's why. Let me just come on over here, and I'm thinking I want to make it longer, so we will edit it that way. Let's see which way was okay, so that's height. I think this is it right. Okay, so I kind of want to just make it not too long, just fairly long. Okay, and I'm just going to copy this, and I'm going to come on over here, and I'm going to paste this, and hit enter, and oops, and then we're going to have to move it to where it looks fairly good. By me not having this highlight, I realize that one of these guys are kind of farther apart. So I'm just going to compensate by moving this one closer. Because most likely I probably did kind of screw up that. So that looks pretty good. Now I'm just going to be lazy and come on over here and hit Shift-D for duplicate. Now if you are in Giants Editor, most likely it's going to be Control-D, I think, for duplicate. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is. Okay, let me just call this front wall. Okay, so
thank you.
what you have to do. You just gotta hit A, and that selects all. And there you go. Everything is selected, except the categories. Those aren't selected. So apparently those won't export with you. Which is kind of sad, because then nothing's organized. Okay, so go up here to File, Export, and then I3D. Now when this comes up, well, first off, just to say, well, let me export this real quick. We're going to call this test I3D. Yeah, okay. So some people also do Control J, and that basically joins everything as one object, which really is kind of because when you get in I3D, you will have one thing and you can't edit any of this stuff in I3D. So if I was to go up here and export this as an I3D, and we call this test 2, okay, and we export this, okay, so it's exported obviously, and I don't know, I won't save this actually. You know what, save. So if we go to, I don't know why I put that weird, but let me just take that one off. Yes, convert it to blend. Sure. Okay, so if we go into, for example, test 2, which is basically all, I joined all that stuff into one object, and say I want to take off the doors or something, you know? And the object it joined everything in was flat roof, so it comes up as flat roof. Well, now everything's flat roof. I can't, like, say I want to take off the doors or something, or say I don't like the tracks, they look kind of stupid, I want to get better textured tracks or something. I can't take those off because it's one object. Everything is in here. And all I have is camera, light, and that object. So, what do I do? Well, I kind of like doing it my way, where I don't join everything. I select all and then export. Because I can do whatever I want. Just in Giant's Editor, I don't have to, like, maybe take it into, like, for example, in the Blender, I don't know if I can take it back in the Blender with, like, if the drawing wasn't on mine, I don't know. I never tried that, but if you look here, I have left door, left track, left wall, right door, right track, right wall, back wall, deck, flat roof, front wall. And so, say I don't like how this right wall is or something, or say I wanted to make this longer, so I want to take this off or something. I can even most likely bring this in, export this all into or import into Blender, and boom, I can do whatever I want in there now. And that's why I like to just hit select all, and it's just nicer. Plus, if I want to, I believe I can just go up here to I think it's transform groups, is actually. Yeah, transform groups, and call it like walls. Oops, probably help if I spell that right. Walls. And then I can go through here and throw in the walls in, and it should show up normal. It shouldn't be anything weird, like certain walls are different appearing. I think that should better be. So, yeah, and also, the light is also inside the building. That's why it's so dark and looks weird. And then all I gotta do is, like, say, for example, I hit Shift A. Bad idea. First off, I select a wall, and I hit Shift A, and I go right wall. Never mind, that won't work because it's gonna select everything with it. Okay, so basically, I select it till it's blue. Click with my mouse button, my scrolling mouse, and I drag and drop in here. And then right wall. I don't know if it show it up as in a conform group, basically, but if I have to, I can take all this stuff out of the transform group and basically throw it in the blender, hopefully. So then I can have some neatness in my stuff. So let me just hit save. And there we go, we got our i3ds. And that's the same way my whatchamacallit is, my bank. And then as you can tell, I have a texture file here, and that's where all my textures go. So I add all my textures in, like the roof, metal roofing and all that junk, in as an i3d. I don't do it through there. And like I was telling you, that this is this is three objects right here. So if you click on it, here's one object. Click on it, here's another object, and then here's another object just covering up because we had a little peak hole that was there. So, and over here is the same exact way. And as you can tell, the camera or the light and everything is inside. And I think even when I come in here, it spawns me inside. I don't remember. But anyways, and if you click on this, we got one here, got one here, got one here, and these are not planes, but they're blocks. Now these are planes. And as you can tell, I wasn't too good at this because it also glitched through the wall there. So, but as you can tell, it's also kind of jagged or kind of messy on that in the like object thing. So anyways, I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. This video, just making it, took like 1 hour 55 minutes. So yeah, hope you enjoyed it. If you'd like to see any more how-tos and stuff like that, please let me know in the comments, and also give it a thumbs up. I hope you all have a great day. Subscribe to my channel if you're new here. See you in the next one. Bye.